video is playing in the background, the president was seeing on this video giving various speeches, all right? We're seeing videotape of events the president has been involved with. We're seeing from election night, videotape from election night itself, in which you will sometimes see, and looks like the video is starting to come maybe to a conclusion, but the president's election night acceptance of his victory. You're seeing from this particular crowd in Lake Charles tonight, you're already beginning to see people clapping loudly and very much supporting this president, President Trump, while booing Rachel Maddow and various mainstream media sources. So it's an interesting time already, more than 8 hours away from the big event, and yet already folks are excited about, and look how many there are as well, excited about the visit of the president. Remarkable to see some of the t-shirts that we have here and some of the signage. Libby, thanks so much for joining us this morning. It is an awesome looking scene, I'll tell you that much. Donta, thank you for your comments. Donta loves what President Trump is doing. I wonder how Donta would feel about this t-shirt to our left. The t-shirt reading, Jesus is my Savior, Trump is my President. And on the back, it refers to the President as the Chosen One. We're setting the scene for you, Lake Charles, right at the lakefront this morning, where we're not even at noontime, and we're already seeing an excited crowd to see the visit of President Donald Trump tonight. As you know, the president has been enmeshed in an impeachment inquiry process already, and that has to overshadow anything we see from the president on the campaign trail. Last night in Minnesota, the president harshly criticized a vocal opponent of his, Democratic Congresswoman Ilhan Omar, the Minnesota Congresswoman who is a part of the squad and has vocally opposed the policies of President Trump. President Trump actually called her last night a disgrace. He also referred to her as an America-hating socialist. As you can tell, the 2020 campaign season is well underway. Jeffrey says he is the chosen one. Jeffrey, thanks for your comments this morning. Charlene saying she loves and supports this president. Thank you so much, Charlene, for being with us. Joe saying, I hope it starts pouring down outside, and it may well. The skies are white at the moment, and it may be a deluge here in a little bit in Lake Charles, Louisiana. Right now it's not, and right now it's a beautiful morning without the typical heat we've seen in recent weeks. We also have a comment from Laura. This is in Lake Charles, ma'am, at the Lake Charles Civic Center. We'll have more on our noon show on 12 News in just a few moments, setting the scene from here at the Civic Center. As is typical with a campaign event, you have the t-shirt sales out front. You have the excited fans essentially around back near the lakeshore this morning. You have the Secret Service working diligently, even though we are several hours away from the event itself. And we have the folks here who are already prepared to be excited and chanting, who dat, supporting their president, President Trump. Let's see if we can focus in on some other folks. We know that that the folks in blue, all the, here's a flag waving an American. Hello, sir. Thank you, sir, for being here today. Whether you support or oppose this president, it's often very exciting to see the exhilaration of folks. If this were, in fact, a Joe Biden rally, for example, I'm sure we would have very excited, very exhilarated folks supporting there. So it's always exciting to see how wound up folks can get for their particular candidate. These folks, very much down here in deep red Louisiana, are very excited about the visit of the president tonight. Big question happens to be, as we were inside just moments ago, putting up gear, preparing that equipment for the sweep of the Secret Service in just a few minutes, We were able to see some of the signs, Make America Great signs up again already this morning, but also signs that say simply, jobs, jobs, jobs. And you can imagine that would be one of the themes that this president would be working on as he tries to make a case for his re-election in 2020. Flag-waving Americans out here. We saw a woman with a t-shirt just a few minutes ago, actually a couple of them, with Women for Trump writing letters on it, as you would say. And so these folks very excited. At least that female demographic is not a demographic that's been lost to the president. Sandra, thanks for your comments this morning. We wish you were here as well. Brenda Jackson says, I'm going. Hard to tell how many hundreds, maybe thousands of people will be here tonight. Remember, we're 8 hours away from the event itself, and we already see roughly a couple hundred people on this side of the building and the other side of the building preparing for the visit of the president. President again in Minnesota last night. Donald Trump Jr. last night with what some have considered controversial comments when he said, lock him up, referring to the Bidens, lock her up as well. Evidently referring to Hillary Clinton, not even in the race. We have expected American politics to get nasty in the past, and we don't expect really any big change in that. The harsh rhetoric may well go in both directions as this campaign season for 2020 gets underway. If you have any further questions, let us know. We'll be happy to try to help. Phyllis commenting this morning, others saying they're almost here. We appreciate your watching this morning. The president and his themes for this particular event are really unclear. We haven't had any advance notice of what the president may want to speak on. But again, when you see a sign in there that says jobs, 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 the president has talked in glowing terms in the past with what he considers a very strong employment picture, especially the employment picture for minorities in America. He has made a case for himself with some regularity that he deserves another 4 years because of the unemployment rate and the economic conditions in the United States at this time. And we're not going to be surprised, having seen the jobs, jobs, jobs sign, if the president doesn't continue with some of that theme tonight. Ironically, we spoke with a woman just a few minutes ago over trying to buy some Trump t-shirts, who referenced her entire family and wanting to buy t-shirts for all of them as well. And she talked about the good conditions in her view. It's a matter of debate whether the American economy is in the shape that Americans want it to be in. Seth asked about the time that the doors open. We know the president speaks at 7 o'clock tonight. Of course, you'll have to go through an extensive screening of the Secret Service as well. The speech is at 7 tonight here again at the Lake Charles Civic Center. I wish I had more information for you as to precisely when the doors will open. We know that we will be able to get back inside with our equipment by 4 this afternoon. And I'm not sure what time the doors open for the public. Do you have any idea what time the doors open for the public? I didn't see anything to that notion. I'll try to check it out. Maybe 4 o'clock for the public as well. Hard to say where these folks, and again, a couple hundred of them around the Civic Center right now. Hard to say what time these folks will be able to get inside and enjoy the cooler temps of the air conditioning. Maybe we could find one of these nice folks and ask them about this visit. Seth, thanks for commenting. Yeah, airport-like security all over the place. Yes, that's to be sure. Mariah, thanks for commenting this morning. Yeah, background checks always a part of this. Susie Phillips. Oh, they're going to quit watching because it's a Trump rally? Tell us more. Tell us more. Maybe you're not a fan of President Trump.
There are a lot of folks that are not.
Adam Brooks reporting, why? Why be here? Why be at a Trump rally? Tell us more. Hector Cruz says, it looks like a Jim Jones gathering, waiting for the Kool-Aid. Thanks for your comments. We accept and appreciate all comments for and against today. Sandra commenting, drain the swamp. No pun intended. We're not even in the swamp. We're in Lake Charles and not even in the swamp. I know what you mean, actually, about draining the swamp. Just playing with you. So we got a young gentleman over here putting up an umbrella in the event that we do get rain. Let's go down the way here. We talked earlier with some folks who were doing the Houdat chant, as you might suspect would be popular here in Louisiana, and doing the Houdat chant for President of the United States. And those nice ladies were all in blue Trump shirts, and I'm not 100% sure where they are. We have a nice Trump, what would you call that? Trump head, the Trump head stick. Not sure what you call that. Good morning, man. Do you have just a moment to talk with me? We're on Facebook Live right now. Hey, Chuck, you want to talk with us real quick?
Yes.
What are you doing here?
Supporting our president.
Okay. Where are you from?
Uptown.
From Oakdale, Louisiana?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Most folks in Oakdale, Louisiana appreciate and support this president.
Oh, yes, they do. Okay. I love President Trump.
We saw inside signs that said jobs, jobs, jobs. Has the president been good for America in terms of jobs and the economy?
Yes, he has.
Tell us.
I'm proud of our president.
Mm-hmm. Tell us about that. You know, on several different occasions, he has made changes in policy to support the energy industry. Does that help you?
Sure, yeah.
Good.
My husband knows more about all that.
You work in the energy industry?
Wood.
Oh, in wood. Okay. So things are going good for y'all?
Yes.
Okay. Well, her husband right here. Tell me your name.
Tina.
And your name?
Aaron.
Thanks so much for your comments. We appreciate you. Are you surprised at how many people we have here this morning?
I actually thought it was going to be more.
There'll be more?
That's why we showed up early.
There's a lot of folks out here. We appreciate you. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
We have a very big crowd already. The irony is that we have, you know, 8 hours to go before we get to anything like a speech from the president. The president spoke last night in Minnesota, and as opposed to particular policy information to convey to the American people, it feels very much like campaign time. Feels very much like re-election time for this president, who has seen flagging support according to some polls in some areas. In fact, taken collectively, many polls show that 5 or 6 Democratic candidates would be capable of beating the president in the 2020 presidential election. But when you look at this crowd, it feels wholly different, doesn't it? A lot of support here in Louisiana. It would not be surprising to be able to talk to any of these folks and have any indication. I'd like to find a moderate in this crowd, somebody who was wondering about whether they would support the president or not in 2020, and yet one is challenged to think how they would find such a moderate in this crowd. But you see a lot of nice folks out here. If I see someone here in a moment where I think I can talk with them, get kind of close enough, well, this gentleman.
Well, that's what I do now.
Our William Blanchette talking with this nice man. William, what's this gentleman?
I'm Kevin,
James. By the way. Nice to see you, James. James, where are you from?
Crawford.
Okay.
Well, I was raised in Beaumont.
How are you?
Good. South Beaumont.
He's been here since 9:30.
Yeah. What's he been? He's been here since 9:30 this morning.
He's got his pillow. You can see his pillow.
Oh, yeah. You're ready.
My wife, Cindy. And we love Trump.
All right, you're not on the fence, as it were.
No, I think
about
he's
Donald
the greatest
Trump,
president in American history.
Tell me what's so great about this president.
Well, he's not a politician, he's a businessman. So when they went to Washington, they said, I don't want your money. Mm-hmm. You can't buy me. You can't bribe me. You can't tell me what to do, because I'm going to do what the American people want us to do.
Okay.
He's for the American people. He did things that they haven't done in 30 years.
Yeah,
he moved the embassy to Jerusalem. They were all cowards. They wouldn't do that. He's told them what they should do about NATO. We've been supporting all these people all over the world, but they don't want to spend a penny on the southern border and securing our border. They want to do everything for all these other countries. They don't want to do anything for America. And all them people up there in Washington, they're corrupt. GOP and the Democrat Party, they're both doing the same thing.
You are very critical of all the sides. Of all the
oh,
parties,
yeah.
Huh?
Oh, yeah. Well, it's the powers. Mitt Romney and Paul Ryan are the reason why this country is in the shape that it's in. If Mitt Romney would have had any kind of backbone and not given up, he would have defeated Barack Obama. And we wouldn't have had 4 years of Barack Obama. We wouldn't have had all this spying, this lying, it's all this slime and everything. And then when they had the House, Paul Ryan worked with Nancy Pelosi to give the Democrats the House. The Democrats did not win the House. Paul Ryan actively worked for Pelosi.
When you are asked by folks whether you are a Republican or a Democrat, what do you tell them?
Well, I tell them I'm a Republican, but, you know...
But you just were critical of several Republicans.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you know, what are you going to do? You don't have any choice.
Yeah.
Donald Trump is not a conservative, and he's not a liberal, and he's not a Republican, really, or a Democrat.
You think Donald Trump's
he's
a Republican?
He's a Republican. Yeah, he took over the Republican Party, and he destroyed the rhinos.
If someone asked you, are you a Trump fan or a GOP fan, what would you tell them?
Trump. No doubt.
First and foremost, you're a Trump fan.
First and foremost.
I hear you.
First and foremost.
Are most people in your town like-minded?
Oh, yeah. Most people in America are like-minded. All these phony polls and all this stuff that you see on the fake news, it's all fake. It's all fake. They make up those polls.
Because we saw a recent Fox News poll, in fact, that showed 51% support for the notion that the president should be removed from office.
But did you do any research on that poll?
Well, the polls, I don't know.
All right, I'll tell you about the polls. The poll was 1,000 people.
Yeah.
1,000 people. They have more than that right here by one company.
Yep.
Okay.
Most of these polls are fairly small samples.
Most of them that they had were Democrats. There were more Democrats that were polled than Republicans. So that was a phony poll.
You're talking about the weighting of the polls, yeah.
They do the same thing on Twitter. Fake trends, fake polls, fake news, we're all against Donald Trump.
Is there any Democrat that you've seen? Joe Biden, Elizabeth Warren, Kamala Harris. Is there any Democrat that you would support?
The Democrats are socialist Marxists. That's what they are. They're Bolsheviks. They want to destroy this country. They want to destroy the Constitution.
I see your views.
They want to take your gun rights away. They want to impose complete and total control over the government by this Green New Deal. All that Green New Deal, all that is just a power grab.
You're not going for that at all.
Oh, no, it's all phony.
What about immigration policy? Has the president done the right things when it comes to that?
Absolutely. He should have done more.
If I'd
have put military all along that border.
Be honest with me. Are you troubled at all by any of the comments the president makes on Twitter or otherwise when it comes to...
No, I'll tell you why. Donald Trump does not speak swamp speak. That's why they can't stand him in D.C. That's why they can't stand him on media. Because he speaks Trump speech. He speaks common sense. He speaks Main Street. He speaks, go in here, sit down by him and have a beer.
Okay.
He speaks the common man. That's why the people love him.
Okay,
see, Trump is the message. In your face, lying media. That's what Trump is. See, Trump is a fighter.
Yep,
and one of his greatest characteristics is he likes to fight. He likes to fight. He's like the guy that goes in the ballroom and says,
like a lawyer who likes to argue.
Yeah, that's right. He says, you want to fight? He said, I ain't going to start it.
But none of his comments on Twitter or otherwise, you're not concerned by any of that. He just referred to having great wisdom the other day seemed like a very brash comment.
He's a very stable genius.
Yeah.
He's a very stable genius.
Let me ask you this, James. Is there anything in the impeachment process, in the impeachment inquiry right now that's troubling to you?
They're trying to negate the voice of the people. They know they can't beat him, so they're going to try to take away our voice. See, what they're doing, that whole impeachment thing, that is against the 63 million people that voted for Donald Trump. See, they're saying your voice don't count.
James, thank you so much, buddy. Appreciate your comment.
Trump
all the way. Thanks so much. Thank you very much.
Well, see, there you have it. You have a staunch elector right here, very much not only in support of the president, but really opposed to some of the conservatives and a lot of Democrats. And yet, very much a big fan of Donald J. Trump. James has referred to him as a man of the people of sorts, as a man who's willing to speak for the people in a common sense way, as James put it. So there's our scene here in Lake Charles at the Beaumont Civic Center, getting a little warm out here right now. And boy, these folks are very excited about the event yet to come. And again, it's hours and hours away. We've neglected some of your comments, and thanks so much for speaking with us this morning, coming online. James for Congress. I think we just got you some votes, James, if you want to run for Congress sometime. Brenda commenting also this morning. Thanks so much for coming by. And let's see, other comments. Speaking as the average American, yes, he has, says Philip Anderson. I work longer hours for more money. Finding jobs is easy now. If you ain't working, it's because you don't want to work. Well, that'll be interesting to talk about tonight, because I think the president is going to be speaking on the employment picture in America. The president has long used the political strategy, if you will, of is your life better today than it was 4 years ago? Presidents in American history have done it many, many times. Are you better off now than you were 4 years ago? President Trump has tried to make the argument that your life is better off. You have a job, and you are getting a decent wage. Well, certainly down here in refinery country in South Louisiana, people are doing fairly well at some of these refinery jobs. We had the great pleasure of speaking at the Cameron LNG not too long ago, and as we have another video begin to come up right now. Actually, let me just shut up and let's listen in a little bit. I hope, Ken, there's not a problem with the video. Thanks for watching. Sandra, thank you for being here this morning. Let's listen into this video this morning. Looky there. Folks, we hope you can hear okay. Liz says you can't hear it. Sorry about that. Yeah, I understand. Yeah, I understand you're having some audio problems. So let's wrap this up this morning. I want you to get a real view of what's going on here along the lakeshore in Lake Charles, Louisiana this morning. 8 hours to go before a Donald Trump rally begins. Kira has been reporting for us this morning. She won't tell us her last name because she's trying to stay anonymous. William Blanchette here with the coverage as well. I'll be here for the next 12 hours trying to get a view for you as to what's going on here at the presidential rally. We may get new comments. We could get news from the president in terms of his election strategy and what he... And we may yet hear some criticism of his potential opponents on the Democratic side tonight. We will let you know what happens in tonight's speech. Lauren says protests on the left. Y'all love to scream about how they don't have a job to be at. Okay. The president... making the case that he believes the employment picture is good in America. Sherry, thank you very much. Well, it's always exciting. As mentioned earlier, if we were at a Joe Biden rally right now, it would be exciting to see how many folks would be that excited about Joe Biden. Boy, I'll tell you, in Lake Charles, it would be hard to believe that they have any Joe Biden fans, although we know they do, right? Tons and tons of folks here at the Lake Charles Civic Center this morning by the lake, by the lakeside, and everybody is starting to sort of just settle in for now. Several hours to go, but the video is playing and everybody is pretty excited about seeing Donald Trump tonight. Thank you so much for watching, and we hope to see you a little later throughout the day. We'll have a report on our 12 news at noon. And we anticipate having coverage throughout the night of the visit of the president to Lake Charles. Thanks for watching. See you later.